Hi y'all, Liz here again today, and we're still talking about the basics of cleaning. We're talking about professional cleaning, right? So it's a different thing than just cleaning your own house. And keeping in mind that your company has a very specific way that it wants things cleaned, and you need to do it that way. It doesn't matter if there's a better way, you know, an easier way, you know, none of that matters, which is a really hard concept for new trainees. We tend to feel like, I've been cleaning whatever it is. I've been cleaning showers for 20 years. I know how to get soap scum off. They're using the wrong this, the wrong that. They're doing it the wrong way, blah, blah, blah. Let all that go. Your job is to learn how to do it the way your company wants it done. Doing it the company's way is more important than doing it the best way, the fastest way, the cheapest way. None of that stuff is as important as doing it the company way. All right. I hope I beat that into you enough. I'm going to probably say it a few more times in other videos, but keep in mind that the company way is the way that's going to keep you employed. And doing it this way is more important because if your boss can't keep track of how things are being done across the whole company, everything can get lost really, really easily. She has no way to answer the question, did they clean my shower? I don't know. Different teams did it different ways, right? So that's why that consistency really matters. Consistency of cleaning in your company. All right. So we're going to talk about the bathrooms today. And I just want to give you a heads up about some of the things that you want to be looking for, thinking about, talking about, asking about. Some of these things you won't clean in your company. Some of these things you will do really detailed cleaning on. I don't know what those are. You need to find out though. I'm just giving you the information to make sure that you ask the right questions and you are paying attention to the right stuff. All right. In every bathroom, you're going to have stuff in the shower. Do you clean those bottles, those containers? I don't know. Need to find out if you do. How about the walls of the showers? Do you use a product, put it on and clean and then rinse? Or do you maybe just steam them? Maybe you just use vapor? Maybe you put water on them first, throw water on, use a wand and get them all wet and then put product on? I don't know. How do you clean the walls on a routine cleaning versus how do you clean on that first clean? Does your company get off hard water? I don't know. Maybe that's a big deal in your company. Maybe it's not. How about soap scum? Do you deal with soap scum? Do you do soap scum on a regular basis or do you do it maybe quarterly or every half year? I don't know what you do. You need to know. Also, the bottom of the bathtubs, where a lot of times you have those little grooves, what do you do for those? Do you just use the same thing that you used on the walls? Do you have a different product? Do you use a different brush? What do you do? The bottom of the shower is almost always going to be done differently than the walls of the shower. So you need to find out what that is. Also, your fixtures. How do you clean your fixtures? Do you take them off to clean them? Do you leave them on? Do you just wipe them? Do you clean them the same way as you're cleaning everything else, but just make sure that you polish them really well when you're done? I don't know. You need to know. Also, that lip on the top of the shower. Do you clean that lip? Most companies clean that lip. If you do, you need to remember to do that. Also, the tracks in the shower. How do you clean those tracks? How do you get between the doors at the bottom? How far up the sides do you go? Do you do the whole things? I don't know, but you need to know. The toilet, cleaning over at the toilet. Almost every single company I've ever seen cleans the whole toilet, top, bottom, inside, outside, along the bottom, behind it, where all of the little hoses connect and the little knobs, wherever the knobs are, all of that gets cleaned. If your company doesn't do that, fine, you need to know that. Most companies will use a pumice stone on the inside of a toilet or a drywall screen or some type of an abrasive to get off any type of rings and streaks. If your company doesn't, great, but you need to know that. How about the mirrors in your bathroom? Does your company use a squeegee, a cloth, a microfiber? Do you not do them? Do you just spot clean them? I don't know, but you need to know. And what kind of cleaner do you use? Do you use a window cleaner? Do you use ammonia? Do you use just plain water? Do you use water and a microfiber? Do you use just steam? I don't know, but you need to know. So what do you, when you're looking in a mirror, you need to ask, what product do I use and what tool do I use to clean the mirror? Same thing with the sinks. You need to ask the same question for the sink that you asked for the shower. What do I clean? Do I clean the sides every single time? Do I use water? Do I use a dry cloth and clean it that way? There are lots of different ways to clean, lots of different companies doing it, lots of different ways, and they all work. You just need to find out what you do in your company and stick with it. Now, if you are used to cleaning with water and you are working for a company that cleans without water, you need to accept that and learn how to do it their way. Vice versa is the same. If you're used to cleaning without water and your company is going to teach you how to clean with water, you need to learn how to do that as well. Period. You have no option. Cleaning bathroom counters is the same as cleaning kitchen counters. You just need to learn how to do it, and you're going to be worried about getting some of those rings off, you know, from glasses and maybe shampoo bottles, that kind of stuff. Hairspray is another consideration in bathrooms. How do you get hairspray off in your bathrooms in your company? Also, rugs. What do you do with rugs? Do the rugs go out of the bathroom before you start cleaning, after you're done cleaning? Do you shake them? Do you vacuum them? Do you take them outside? Handling rugs is really different in all companies. You need to find out what you do. When you're done cleaning the bathroom, do the rugs go back? Do they get rolled up outside the door? Do they get folded? What happens with the rugs? All of these ways are ways that people actually deal with rugs. How about the trash in the bathroom? Do you empty it or not? If you do empty it, you better figure out how to find it. Where is it? How are you going to figure out where it is and remember it every single time? If you don't empty it if you're not supposed to empty it. Okay, and then what about the light bars? Light bars is one of those things that is really tricky to clean. No matter which company you work for, if you clean light bars, make sure that the bulbs are cool before you start cleaning. Whether you clean them dry or wet, they still need to be cool when you clean them. All right, I think I hit all of the basics. Of course, there's always knickknacks in bathrooms. There's always towel racks. There's towels themselves that either need to be folded or not folded. We hit on the basics today. So remember to ask all of these questions. So my question today is, of all of the things that I said, which thing did you hear that you thought, people do that? That's weird. Okay, talk to you tomorrow. Bye.